was actually going to be my next point, because obviously you and Stern were kind of at the top of the boards there for a while. And you mentioned kind of his interviewing style, because, you know, like, I'll listen to him and everybody will listen to him, and every now and then he'll ask a question, he'll phrase it in a way that I feel is just, like, totally disrespectful, and I would think, like, if I asked it that way, I'd just get slapped in the face. You know, like how are you able to, like, ask personal questions like that without, you know, insulting or offending people?
Well, Howard can do it today because he's a bigger star than almost all of the guests that he has on his show.
Yeah.
So once you get that leverage, you can pretty much do whatever you want. In the early days, there were three of us, Jack. There were myself, Howard Stern, and a guy that you've probably never heard of. His name was the Grease Man.
Wow.
And he was in Washington, D.C., and the three of us were the first ones to be called, in those days, they would, you know, call us a different brand of radio than anybody else. You know, they would call it raunch and roll, or they would call us shock jocks, or whatever it was. That's fine. Howard broke out because he was the first one to accept a gig to do it on a syndicated basis. It wasn't that he was better or more talented. He was just the first one who was willing to move to New York and do it on a syndicated basis. I didn't want to move to New York. You know, I was recently married, and I just love Arizona and didn't want to go there. Doug, the Grease Man, was too old. So Howard was the first to do it, and he deserves credit. But it wasn't that he was this breakout talent. Over the years, Howard just got better and better and better, and he became an incredible talent. And then, you know, once he developed a name, it got a lot easier for him. But he's a good interviewer now. If you can get past all the shock stuff that he does and really listen to his interviews, he does a really good job.
Have you ever heard anything from anybody that you've interviewed that he's interviewed, and, like, just from a reputation basis? Like, did they think he was a nice guy? Was he an asshole? Like, based on his interviewing skills.
I mean, you know, I worked with him a lot of years, and I can tell you he's a great guy.
Yeah.
And I don't care what anybody says, and sometimes reputation can kind of get out in front of you to where people start telling stories that aren't necessarily true, and it gets to be competitive. But I can tell you personally that he's a great guy. He's very warm and very good, and he's worked very hard. Now, he sacrificed a lot to get to where he is. He sacrificed his family. So it's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
You know, at one point early in my career, we were sitting on a panel together or something, and I said, buddy, you changed the whole culture of radio. You changed the whole game. You made more money than anybody in radio. And he said, Dave, you're wealthier than I am. And I laughed. I said, yeah, right. And he goes, no. He goes, you got your whole family. He goes, you got everything. And what I think he was trying to say was that he sacrificed a hell of a lot.
Yeah.